Welcome to another edition of Ask Loy, brought to you by Tropic Isle Living, the natural and the traditional way to an absolutely healthy, beautiful you. And today we're going to be talking about chocolate ball tea, or cocoa tea as we call it in Jamaica. It's the season for the chocolate ball to come out and really shine. And you know, chocolate is also known as the food of love. So for the holiday season, I'm just going to show you how to make a good chocolate ball tea, or cocoa tea, or hot chocolate. The ingredients that you need to use is almond milk, but you can substitute with soy milk if you want to, or 2% cow's milk, even though I'd rather use almond milk. And then you need a grater to grate the cocoa balls, okay, which is right here. These are the cocoa balls. Then you also need a nutmeg, okay, not the powdered one, not the one that they sell in the store, but get a whole nutmeg, all right? Then you need a nutmeg grater, and you also need cinnamon leaves and cinnamon sticks. Now, I like to use these all natural products in its all natural state because it just enhances the flavor. You're also going to need to use 1 cup of water. This is my cup that I use, to be honest with you, to 2 cups of almond milk, and you can even increase it to 3 cups because it unites. I like the nice little creamy feel that it brings. So when we come back, I will show you how to grate the coconut, not the coconut. And you know what? I forgot. You can also put coconut milk in there too if you like. But for now, we're not going to do that, okay? We come back and I'll show you how to grate the cocoa ball as well as the nutmeg. Okay, now that you've seen me grate both the chocolate ball as well as the nutmeg, I'm going to pour in first the 1 cup of water, okay? Right here we have the cup of water. We also have 2 cups of the almond milk, but as I said, you can add another extra one for creaminess. If you don't like it too sweet, I would not put any sugar in this combination. If you want it a little bit sweet, then obviously you can add any organic sugar or brown sugar. Do not use the white sugar, use the brown sugar. Trust me, just tastes a little bit different, okay? So first you add your water, okay? And then after you add your water, you are going to add your cinnamon stick, all right? And your cinnamon leaves. Now, at this point, what I will do is start boiling the mixture in the water. And then after I start seeing that you have some flavor, you're smelling the cinnamon, then and only then you add the chocolate, okay? After that, you let it boil again until you figure that it has melted, okay? And you're gonna see exactly what I'm doing, but I'm gonna talk you through the process. After you boil the cinnamon and then you feel like it's smelling up and nice aroma is coming from the pot, then add your chocolate. And then after you do that, wait until it also melts away and then add your nutmeg, just a pinch of nutmeg, just to taste. Some people like a lot of nutmeg. I say just do a pinch first and then you can just add as you go along as the boiling process. After you add your nutmeg and you let it boil again, okay, because it's continually boiling this time, you're gonna add your 1 cup of almond milk or whatever milk you wanna use, and then keep on adding the others. So it's just thinking about like you're layering the chocolate, okay? And then you can also do a taste test as you go along, okay? So we'll be right back. I'm gonna put this beautiful pot on the stove and start the process, okay? Thank you. you've seen the process, okay? The end result now is the boiling, and I'm stirring while we boil. And if you notice, there's not as much granules in the hot chocolate mixture because it is melting out. Now, what I forgot to tell you is that you can add sugar. I think I did, but you know what? When you turn 45, certain times the memory just goes and you don't remember what you told anybody. Anyway, so you keep on stirring, okay? But just note that not all of the sediments will also melt out, okay? And that is okay. If you don't like the sediment to be in your tea when you're finished boiling it, what you can do is take a strainer and you strain it through the strainer while you are pouring it into a cup. But I happen to like the sediment and the gritty because I just like it in its natural state, okay? So it's almost finished. You keep boiling and you keep boiling as much as possible as you can. And what I do sometimes is that I will leave it and let it sit so that the herbs can really seep into the flavor and then reheat it again. I will drink it throughout the course of the day. Now what I forgot also to tell you, it is also excellent for women who are experiencing menstrual cramps or even PMS. As I said, chocolate is, you know, brings a nice feeling of euphoria. And I'm not sure if you guys know, but back in the slavery days, Sir Hansel, I forgot his name, was a historian, and he saw that the slaves were putting chocolate in their breast milk and feeding their babies. You know, chocolate is just a powerful food, high in antioxidants. And there's so many things about all these different herbs that I'm putting in there. To be honest with you, this is just a lovely health concoction that absolutely tastes well and tastes good. That I, you know, I just love making during the holidays, okay? So bon appetit. I hope your hot chocolate comes out as good as mine. If you don't like it too strong, you can always add your milk or your milk substitute, like I use this almond milk. And you can also sweeten to taste, as well as you can add some more spice to taste, okay? But I just gave you just the foundation of how to start. Through all the process, and now you've seen the end results. I have my lovely peppermint stick here that I'm using just to kind of like just add a little bit more flavor to it. And you can drink this as you stir, or you can chew your peppermint and drink as well. Alrighty then, I hope you've enjoyed this segment of Ask Lois, brought to you by Tropic Isle Living, the natural and the traditional way to a healthy, beautiful you. Remember to like us on Facebook. We also have our Instagram page that you can probably even join us and see what's going on. And also we have our tweeting that you can also get a lot of information about what we do. We're not only about the Jamaican black castor oil, we are the natural and the traditional way to a healthy, beautiful you. So look us up. We have so many products that will suit your everyday needs that will just make you healthy, beautiful, and wise. Thank you again for joining us at Ask Lois, brought to you by Tropic Isle Living.